No, I figured out how to stop it.
Who was it?
I don't care. Someone immature. Stupid. Oh my god, if they don't have...
I think that's just cover up.
Yeah.
I've got killed like five.
But
isn't
that?
Who's kicking me?
Right, I'm not sure if I can go through this on Teams. I'll try once more, otherwise I'm supposed to talk. Right, okay, here we go. So, this is language, right? So, this is writing. So, let me just talk to you about what you need. So, you've got, it's 40 marks, and you have content and organisation, right, which is actually what you're doing and who you're writing for. And then you've also got AO6, which is technical accuracy, which is spelling, punctuation, grammar, which is only worth 16 marks, right? So,
do you lose a mark?
Yeah. So if you're dyslexic, you get zero. No. Right. Let's go from here. Right. So let's get the top marks. Shh. Let me just talk you through this. Right. Register is convincing and compelling for the audience. So the very first bullet point that you see is all about writing correctly for your audience. So if you know who your audience are and you know what they are going to do and you know what you want them to do, the more you can put that into your writing, the better mark it's going to be. All right. So don't just write your A4S techniques if they're not important. Write to your audience. Jakey, do you understand that? And the second bullet point is assuredly match to purpose. So if you're writing to explain, you're explaining. If you're writing to argue, you argue. You know what you've been asked to do and you can do it. All right. Right. Extensive and ambitious vocabulary. So what that means is try and use ambitious vocabulary. Where's that coming from?
That's right now. It's like.
Can someone just go on his door and just knock and ask him? You know, can you just go and ask him to turn it down slightly?
He's going to be that guy.
Oh. I told him, thanks. Thank you. Just say, can you turn it down, please? Otherwise, this son will come and headbutt you. So when you go through this, varied and inventive use of structural features, make sure you use paragraphs. If you don't use paragraphs, I'm going to be like wild. You must use paragraphs, okay? Integrate discourse markers. What's a really good thing that you would use, David, as a discourse marker? What's a discourse marker? Oh, come on. Firstly, secondly, thirdly, moving on. So you're showing that there's links between the paragraphs, okay? Register is convincingly matched to audience. So make sure you know who you're writing to. Okay. A teenager. Well, a teenager would be where you use humour. Hi, guys. Just think of me, just think of like slightly more than Mr. Tumble, think of Grandpa Tumble. Hello, I'm Justin. And then to get those top marks, Range of punctuation is used. What are you going to be using? Not just your old full stops and commas. What else? Exclamation marks. Question marks. Girls at the back, what else would you be using? Colons, semicolons, yeah. What else? Ellipses. Try and do one sentence, one word sentences as well. They're brilliant. No. Yeah, 1,000%. Anything you do, if you're arguing for something, say, I have created a website. It is called www.nouniformforfreedomcollege.org or something like that. Make it up. Yeah. Yeah.
You've got to really be over
Yes, you have to be over exaggerated, and you have to be like, you know, if you've got a swap that was like, hi guys, you've got to be like that, like be like Hermione Granger if she was going to do something.
Teenagers.
Yeah.
Hey, my name's Ames.
How are you today? Hands up, who's had a good day? She's so good. Right. A variety of sentence forms, so use your short sentences for effect, all right? What do you think? Agree? That was my, like, agree? One word sentence. Sophisticated vocabulary. So if in doubt, use the word, don't worry about spelling. It's better to use sophisticated vocabulary and spell it wrong than it is to play it safe and spell it right.
What if it's like so spelled wrong
The examiner will be able, just spell it phonetically if you don't know. The examiner will be, it's more important to spell things wrong but use them. Yeah. Yeah, but that's in paper one. No, these are the same. Literature's shortened. The next literature exam will be shortened because that's.
Like, how long is. You said 2 hours.
We used to have an exam, it was 2 hours and 15 minutes, but you're not doing that one anymore because we have, we're not doing curious. So that used to be. Curious, poetry anthology, unseen poetry, comparative unseen poetry.
So we're not doing.
You're not doing
one exam.
No, you're not doing a part of one exam.
Yeah, sorry. I mean, now,
like, no, and you're not doing paper one because you should have done that. That's the one that we did about Zoe going down the mountain and crashing. That was paper one. So you've done that. We've practiced it already. Getting caught in that avalanche.